just because you haven't gotten sick doesn't mean you won't. And in fact, statistically, you will.
Here's the thing with COVID, and I've been doing this for 25 years. I've never seen people get sick from a virus like people get sick from COVID. It's going around the globe and around the globe. Eventually, most people that aren't vaccinated are gonna get COVID.
Right. COVID is going to happen because of the way this virus is hitting our population and the way it's mutating. If you don't get the vaccine, you're really choosing between getting the vaccine or accepting that you're going to get COVID.
Yeah, there's always that guy that does all the things that they're not supposed to do and never gets sick. But the case fatality is still 1.8%. And I know that sounds low because people say 98.2% of people recover. But that's like the chances of being in a car accident and dying if you don't have a seatbelt. And that's something that we think about happening all the time. And we take steps so that it doesn't happen.
So I've got a question, Karen. Isn't natural immunity from COVID much better than getting immunity from a vaccine? I mean, why take that risk? Let's just naturally get immune to this.
Well, that would be great if COVID were a really mild illness, for one thing. But the thing is, when you get COVID out in the wild, so to speak, you develop a very specific immune response to that specific virus that you got, that very specific strain. Vaccines actually help your body to recognize a virus a little more broadly. So it helps your body to recognize the infections from multiple strains of a virus. And the newest studies are showing that vaccine immunity is working better against these newer mutations than the natural immunity. And the people that got an early strain of COVID, the people that got it in February or March of 2020, are going to be susceptible to these newer strains. I know I have a lot of patients that don't like to get vaccines because they swear that they get sick. They get the illness from the vaccine. Jackie, want to talk about that?
Yeah, that short answer is no, you cannot get COVID from the COVID vaccine. And it's very simple. There isn't any actual virus alive or dead in any of these vaccines.
This vaccine does pack a little bit of a punch, and it has to do with how COVID infects our bodies. That spike protein that we're training your body to recognize by giving you the vaccine, it does cause an inflammatory reaction.
Our bodies think that they're sick.
So it is very common, especially with that protein and the way that that protein causes the horrible infection that it does, that even with the little bit that you're getting in the vaccine to teach your body to recognize it, your body's going to give you a fever and make you feel achy. And often for how long did you feel kind of crummy after you got the vaccine? About 18 hours?
It varies from person to person. But the point is, your body might think it's getting sick, but there's no infection.
So, Jack, there have been some recent reports of some potential heart problems after vaccination.
Our bodies are responding very aggressively to those proteins, which is necessary to teach our bodies how to fight these germs off. But unfortunately, that may also create inflammation in our bodies. That's a temporary thing. But in a very few patients, that's become a bit more of a problem. And this is really a great example of how that post-vaccine monitoring works, like that VAERS database, because they picked this up very quickly. And they've already done several studies looking at this particular side effect. And it's not an infection. It's just a little bit of inflammation, like your muscle would get sore in your arm after you work out or something like that. That's inflammation happening in a muscle of your arm. And the heart doesn't stop working, but the heart does start acting sick. If the problem occurs, most of the time it occurs within just a couple of days of getting the vaccine. So this isn't like a ticking time bomb that's, you know, we're waiting to go off. This is something, if it's going to happen, it's going to happen very quickly. And for those cases that were reported to the VAERS database, by the time they'd had a chance to identify them, they'd already recovered. These folks. So let's say we give 1 million second doses of the mRNA COVID-19 vaccine, 12 to 29 years. And let's say we don't want to give those because of those rare cases of myocarditis. So we just decide not to vaccinate those folks. What we've just asked for is 11,000 COVID-19 cases, 560 hospitalizations, 138 intensive care unit admissions, and 6 deaths due to COVID-19, compared with maybe 30 or 40 expected myocarditis cases after that 1 million were vaccinated and no deaths. This is a case, like anything, of balancing risk versus benefit. And we make those judgments every time we get into a car to go to the store to get groceries for our family. We make that risk-benefit judgment when we're giving this vaccine. The risk of not vaccinating is so, so much higher than the risk for this particular vaccine.